Rant and rave. Here we go. Let's first start with a little football, Tucker. Will our boy Jake Fromm, of course, the Buffalo Bills, will he ever really be a starter in the NFL? What do you think?
Well, a lot of people say he's going to be a career journeyman backup guy, and he could certainly fit that role. But all it takes is one injury, and he's in as the starter. And I think once he's the starter, he has what it takes to prove that he can remain a starter. But I do think that he's going to probably need an injury. I mean, he could go in and beat out Allen in camp. They got him for a reason. Obviously, they think he might have a chance to do that. But I think if he has if Allen has an injury, then Fromm may never lose the job. Look at Eason.
Absolutely, no doubt. That's a possibility. I kind of compare him. He was compared a lot to Kirk Cousins a couple weeks ago before the draft. Of course, Cousins taken later in the draft by the Redskins, got the job in RG3, got injured and couldn't really play. And then Cousins got a huge contract from the Vikings. I compare him to Nick Foles. You know, Foles got the opportunity with the Eagles when Carson Wentz was hurt, won them a Super Bowl, then got traded to the Jaguars, and now, traded to the Bears, and we'll see if he can beat out Trubisky. I can kind of see that same kind of scenario playing out for Jake, where he gets a chance, helps the team win, and may bounce around a little bit, but, if he gets a shot, he could help, even if it's a short-term situation. So let's hope he will get that chance, if not in Buffalo, somewhere else down the road. All right, baseball. Did you actually watch the Korean baseball that came on and is coming on late at night? Well, you know, Tuck, considering my age, sometimes I have to get up in the middle of the night. So I did kind of take a little peek at it. It was weird with no fans, and they swing at everything over there. I wish I could pitch. I may be able to get some of these guys out, even at my age. But I'm not going to stay up and watch it. I'm not even DVRing it. I'm just going to let it play and see some of the highlights and hope and pray we can get real baseball soon.
Well, as far as the first game, of course, it was supposed to start at 1 o'clock a.m. our time, and then there was a rain delay, so, of course, we had to wait even longer for something. I stayed up that night, got home, and told my wife I was going to watch some Korean baseball, and she looked at me like I was crazy and went to bed. Then it started to rain, of course, but I stayed up, and the most entertaining part to me was actually the interview they did with Eric Thames talking about his time over in Korea. It was interesting to hear some of the experiences he had, like saying the players get off the bus and shove hot noodles in their mouths and stuff like that. It was kind of weird for him to see, but I enjoyed those stories. The game itself, I only lasted through three innings, and I finally had to hit the heck.
Was it exciting baseball or weird because there's no crowd?
They seemed to have some kind of filtered crowd noise. I don't know what that was, but it didn't seem that bad. But the baseball itself wasn't bad. I mean, I guess you could kind of compare it to XFL. It was a decent product, but you knew it wasn't the best of the best.
And they did manipulate the camera angles to make it not so obvious that there was nobody in the stands, which is probably what they're going to do around here, I would imagine, as well. All right, so what's better, old wrestling matches or old baseball games? Well, Tuck, if it's certain kind of wrestlers like Ric Flair, I'll take the old wrestling even over the old baseball games. How about you?
Yeah, if it's old, I want some jam-packed action. I don't want any waiting around and watching balls and strikes. I want some action. So I'm not a huge wrestling fan, but in this case, in this particular question, I'll go wrestling if we're talking about old events.
Yeah, we're having to watch a lot of old stuff, that's for sure. All right, final question. When do we start making up fake trade rumors? Tucker, right here and now. Here you go. There's no trades allowed, and that means there's no trade rumors. We're going to make one up. Francisco Lindor said the other day that he's not going to sign with Cleveland. So you know what? Dansby Swanson, Bryce Wilson, Tucker Davidson, and a low A pitcher to Cleveland for Francisco Lindor. Let's start this fake trade rumor and let it trend on Twitter. What do you think?
There you go. You know, you as a sports talk show host have nothing else to do right now but make up fake trade rumors. You've had plenty of time to think about your possible scenarios. I'll stick with that one. I like that one. I like how that one goes.
Lindor comes to Braves. They're going to get a World Series trophy with an asterisk right by it. And we'll take it. Every time we'll take it, no doubt. That's Rant and Rave for this week.